Kishkindha Kand ended with Angad and his group reaching the southern coast and Sampati telling them the whereabouts of Sita. Hanuman, recalling his true powers, readied himself with immense confidence to leap across the ocean to find Sita, where Sundarkand begins. Roaring Jai Shri Ram, Hanuman took a giant leap. On his way, the mountain Menak raised up to offer him some rest, but Hanuman politely refused, as he was in a hurry. The Devas, to test his bravery and intellect, sent the Nagmata Sursa. Hanuman requested her to let him go as he was on a very important mission. But she had a boon from Brahma that anybody who crossed her would have to enter her mouth. Hanuman thus increased his size manyfold, and so Sursa kept widening her mouth. In an instant, he reduced himself to the size of a thumb and swiftly flew in and out of her mouth, thus passing the test of wits. Further on his way, a sea monster named Simhika captured his shadow and stopped his movement. She then swallowed him and he had to tear his way out. Finally, he landed on Lanka and observed the beautiful city from a safe distance. At night, he tried to jump his way in, but was stopped by Lankini, the protector of Lanka. In spite of his repeated request, she refused entry and slapped him, saying that no one had ever gone past her. Losing his patience, Hanuman hit her hard with his left fist. She remembered Lord Brahma's foretelling that a day will come when she is defeated by a monkey, which is when Ravan's downfall will begin. She left Lanka, allowing Hanuman to enter. Once inside, Hanuman searched everywhere and eventually entered Ravan's palace. He saw Ravan's wife Mandodari, adorned in silk and jewels, sleeping peacefully. Seeing her beauty, he wondered if that might be Sita, but immediately dismissed it, certain that Sita would not be enjoying comforts in captivity. Finally, he reached Ashok Vatika and saw a beautiful woman sitting forlorn in worn-out clothes. Confident that he found Sita, he hid in a tree to wait and learn more. At dawn, Ravan visited Sita and once again tried convincing her to be his wife. When Sita continued to rebuke him for his misdeeds, he was enraged and gave her 2 months to consent, failing which he would eat her for breakfast. By Ravan's orders, the demonesses guarding Ashok Vatika used all means to scare and convince her. One of them, named Trijada, drove them away and protected Sita, reassuring her that Ram will rescue her. After witnessing these events, Hanuman worried that his sudden appearance might scare her. So he recited the story of Ram still hidden and then revealed himself. Sita still feared that this was another one of Ravan's tricks. So to earn her trust fully, he narrated Ram's story in more detail, starting from his birth, wedding, exile and Sita's abduction. He further explained Ram's friendship with Sugriv and the events that had followed up till the moment he met her. He then gave her Ram's ring as final proof. Sita was overwhelmed. He offered to take her back to Ram on his shoulders, but Sita refused. She believed that only Ram himself can rescue and redeem her. To reassure Ram that Hanuman met her, she told him a story that only Ram and her knew. She also gave him her last remaining jewel, her Chudamani, which is a hairpin. To send a warning message to Ravan, Hanuman started creating chaos in the garden. When the demons reported the trouble caused by a powerful monkey, Ravan sent 80,000 Kinkaras, followed by Jambu Mali and 5 other generals. Hanuman killed them all, including Ravan's son Akshakumar. Finally, Ravan's eldest and most prolific son, Indrajit, used Brahmastra on Hanuman. Hanuman agreed to be politely bound by it. When the demons tied him up, the effect of the Brahmastra faded. Yet he remained bound because he was eager to meet Ravan himself. In Ravan's court, he introduced himself as the envoy of King Sugriv and Ram and advised Ravan to release Sita to save himself from Ram's fury. Enraged, Ravan ordered Hanuman's execution, but his wise brother Vibhishan stopped him as it was unethical to kill an envoy. Instead, he advised to send Hanuman back injured, so Ravan ordered to set his tail on fire. When this news reached Sita, she prayed to Agnidev, the god of fire, to protect Hanuman. Surprised that the fire did not hurt him, Hanuman flew all around Lanka and set the whole city ablaze. He returned to Ashokvatika to ensure Sita was unaffected by the fire. With her blessing, Hanuman leapt back across the ocean, touching Mount Menak on his way. He landed with a jubilant roar and recounted all the events to Angad and his group. They wanted to declare war against Lanka, rescue Sita and go back to Ram with her. But Jambavan dissuaded them to not act without Ram's orders. They began their return journey to Kishkindha and stopped at Madhuvan, a place full of honey and fruits. Dadimukh, Sugriv's uncle, who guarded that place, tried to stop them but was driven away by them. When he complained, Sugriv deduced that the mission must have been a success. Realizing their service to Ram, Dadimukh apologized to Angad and escorted them all to Sugriv's court. At Mount Prasavna, Hanuman informed Ram that Sita had been found, narrated all the events and gave him Sita's Chuda money. Ram was elated to hear that Sita was safe and awaiting his arrival, marking the end of the fifth part of Ramayana, Sundarkand.